We just thank God for allowing us to assemble in this place one more time. You know, we don't know when we leave out of this facility what's going to be, what will stand ahead of us, what's ahead of us. But there's one thing this scripture has been, this passage of scripture has been on my heart all this week, and it's one of my favorite ones. And you may turn there with me. It's Psalms 91. Psalms 91. Could I have a podium, please? I can see a little better with a little higher. Psalms 91. God, that's better. Glory to God. All right, you can just follow along with me, but I want to say a few words before. I think this is a scripture that we can read, not necessarily the whole thing, but it wouldn't hurt to, on a daily basis, to confess the word just before whatever we're going to do. During that day, to just ask God to be our protection, you know, because we never know what's out there, what will befall us. This is abiding in the shadow of the Almighty. And we know that when you abide, you live there. You stay there. You just stay in His presence. And that doesn't mean you have to be on your knees all the time. It doesn't mean that you have to be holding your hands up all the time. You can abide in His presence when you're driving. You can abide in His presence where you're just sitting and just thinking of the goodness of God. So we're going to go out and read Psalms 91. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress, my God. In Him will I trust. Surely He shall deliver thee from the snare of the fowler and from the noisome pestilence. He shall cover thee with His feathers, and under His wings shalt thou trust. His truth shall be thy shield and buckler. Thou shalt not be afraid for the terror by night, nor for the arrow that walketh, that flieth by day, nor for the pestilence that walketh in darkness, nor for the destruction that walketh wasted at noonday. 1,000 shall fall at thy side, and 10,000 at thy right hand, but it shall not come nigh thee. Glory to God! Only with thine eyes shall thy behold and see the reward of the wicked. Because thou hast made the Lord, which is my refuge, even the Most High, thy habitation. There shall no evil befall thee, neither shall any plague come nigh thy dwelling. For He shall give His angels charge over thee, to keep thee in all thy ways. They shall bear thee up in their hands, lest thou dash their foot against a stone. Thou shalt tread upon the lion and adder, the young lion and the dragon shalt thou trample under feet. Because He has set His love upon me, therefore will I deliver him. I will set him on high because he hath known my name. Glory to God. He shall call upon me, and I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble. I will deliver him and honor him. With long life will I satisfy him and show him my salvation. Look at the promises that God has made in that passage of Scripture. He said He would deliver us. He would protect us. He has set us on high. He will be our refuge. He will be our fortress. What a refuge is a place where we can go and in seclusion for safety. And he would be our fortress. What's a fortress? A fortress is a protection. And it's just, if you can envision like a wall around you and the enemies were coming in against you, that wall will help to just throw that. That's what he said he would be for us. He would be that for us. And he said he'll be our buckler. He will be our shield. A shield is also a protection. So in this passage, he's saying that I will be for you what you need me to be. Whatever you need me to be, that's what I'll be for you. But now the first part of that scripture is God's promises are, most of his promises are contingent upon us doing something. And that is, and he said, he that dwelleth in the secret place. That secret place is a place of obedience. And when we are obedient to his word, then he said we can command ye me. We can command him like Hezekiah did. And that's why so many times I like to go over in the corner, and it's just symbolic, and face the wall. It's symbolic because when I go there, I says, Lord, you said, he said to put his promises before him, to his words, put it before him. And we can do that and say, Lord, you said this. And if I've done this, Sister Dorothy, then I don't have to worry about what he's going to do. I don't have to worry about what he's going to do if I've done it. It may be delayed, but it won't be denied. Hallelujah. Glory to God. So we have two more days of prayer, morning prayer. And at the beginning of prayer, our Sister Dorothy and we agreed that we would ask for three things for God to do for us, just three things. And I have my three. And at the end of the prayer, we want you to, end of the time of prayer, look over the three things you've written down. We ask you to write them down and see where you are on those, to see if God has answered it, either one or all of them. And if not, why not? It could be that it's delayed. It could be that it's not time. The timing is not right. And it could be that you need to revamp it. So we just didn't want to come out and idly pray. We wanted to have a focus. So we want you to examine that. But also, before I take my seat, I want, if you have your book, this is a great book, a prayer book. This one, Prevailing Prayer. Okay, let's turn to page 33. It may be a different page in yours, but it's a prayer of commitment, casting all your cares. Prayer of commitment, casting all your cares. All of them, not some of them, all of them. Casting all your cares. How many do we have? Sometimes too many to name. Cast them all on him. And cast means to not just go in, this is, and just, well, Lord, I'm going to lay them down right here. No, that's not what he said. He said cast them. When you cast something, you just throw it over there, and you don't go back and get it. You leave it there. Leave it at his feet. Leave it there. Praise God. If you're there, it reads thusly. Father, I know you will perfect that which concerneth me. I come to you with all my cares. I know that you care for me and you promise to sustain me when I cast my burden upon you. You invited me to come boldly before the throne to obtain mercy and find grace to help in time of need. So here I am. Hallelujah. Here I am. Father, I submit myself to you and am releasing my cares. I resist the devil in Jesus' name, and he must flee from me. I resist the cares of life which try to pressure me and burden me down daily. I acknowledge my need and my complete dependence upon you. Except the Lord builds a house, they labor in vain who build it. Lord, you promise rest to those burdened and laden with cares. Let me read that again. Lord, you promise rest to those burdened and laden with cares. There is a rest for the people of God. A rest where I cease from my weariness, toils, and human labors, just as you ceased from all your works at creation. You promised to strengthen me, help me, and to uphold me when I pass through the waters and walk through the fire. You assured me that the rivers would not overflow me, nor would the flames be kindled upon me. Father, I make this appeal not because of my righteousness or good works, but on the basis of your faithfulness and your mercy. Your word says that you would be gracious unto me when you hear the voice of my cry, and you would answer. You delight in mercy and showing favor, and rejoice when your children appear before your throne. It is your desire to see all my needs met and my joy full. Lord, I thank you, for you will never allow me to slip, fall, or fail, as long as I am walking in obedience to your word. I thank you that your presence goes with me, and that you give me rest. I will not fret myself, nor will I let my heart be troubled, neither shall I let it be afraid. I enter into my rest prepared and waiting for me from the foundation of the world. I will cast all my cares upon you. I will lay all my burdens down at your feet. At any time I don't know what to do, I will cast all my cares upon you. In Jesus' name, amen. And amen. Now we're going to come, and Sister Dorothy is going to pray, and we're going to cast all of the cares, whatever it is that you brought in here this morning, the cares. We don't want you to, you heard the word. You don't need to take it out here. And you don't need to pick it up ever again. That's the promise that he has given us. And that's what he's told us to do. And he has never given us erroneous information. Never, never. And so if those things that you have been asking God to do for you, if they haven't come to fruition, just remember, it may be delayed, but it's not denied, as long as we are walking in obedience to his word. Sister Dorothy. Oh, yes. She might want to sing it, huh? Come on, Sister Dorothy. From you withhold all the siblings, go, and you have to get along on a meager fare. Just remember in God's word how he feeds a little bird. What?
Take your burden.
Take your burden. Sister Dorothy, just do a little run on that, please. Praise God. Hallelujah. Glory to God.
These morning prayers have been such a blessing. I can see where I have grown. I have grown in faith. I have grown in patience. I have learned to listen to what God is saying. I've learned to listen to what he's not saying. Sometimes he's not saying anything. But I'm learning how to just hold on. Just hold on. Hold on. You're talking to your daddy. Daddy's going to answer you back. Just give him up. Just hold on. And that's what I'm learning. Praise God. Hallelujah. If the world from you withhold all of its silver and all of its gold, and you have to get along on meager fare, remember in God.
how he feeds and takes care of every little bird. You can take your burdens, no matter what they are, to the Father. Trials dark on every hand. Sometimes we just don't. We really can't understand all the ways that God will lead us to His blessed promise. If you make it by faith, He'll make two. We can take our burdens. We can take our cares. We can take temptations. We can take our burdens. We can take our woes. We can take our trials. We can take our sins, no matter what they are, to the Father. Can leave them there.